Hi everyone, and how are you doing today? I bring you greetings in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ and also on behalf of Christ of Pentecost Global Ministry. And I want to share with you what we learned today in the house of God. Today we're giving a topic that says spiritual gate, and our anchor scripture was taken from the book of Psalm 24 from verse 1 to 10. The book of Psalm 24 verse 1 to 10. And what are spiritual gates? We were taught that these are forces that exercises authority or dominion over systems, over nations, over families, over individuals, over entities. Praise God. We further learned that this gate has its own strategy of debarring people of achieving or possessing what God has in store for them. I pray that you and I, we shall not be limited in the name of Jesus Christ. Praise God. And what are these strategies? We were given the word fear. The second one talks about the arrow of propaganda. Another one talks about the power of lust. And the fourth one talks about the violation of spiritual laws. Praise God. And we were also taught how to deal with this gate. Praise God. We were taught that as a child of God, we must have authority. Praise God. And what is this talking about? It talks about you knowing your command and also able to identify your authority in Christ Jesus. Praise God. And also, as in the course of the study of today, something caught my attention and I wrote it down. The man of God said, the fact that you have a call of God upon your life or that you are a minister does not mean that gate cannot debar you. Praise God. But gate would only not have power over you when you exercise your authority. And how do you exercise this authority? That is when you find your identity in Christ Jesus. And how can you find your identity in Christ Jesus? This is when you settle down with the word. Praise God. When you create time to read the word of God, to hear God speak to you. And I pray that as you do, I pray that Holy Spirit, our teacher, he will teach you into the in-depth of the word of God. It will give you understanding. It will open your spiritual eyes to be able to see the power and the authority that our Lord God Almighty has for us in Christ Jesus, his only begotten Son. Praise God. And I pray that as you go this week, I pray that the Lord will go with you in the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord will order your step in Jesus' name. And whatsoever that stand as gates before you that might have been limiting you, today in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, they are lifted up forever in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The Lord will bless and keep you. The Lord will make his face to shine upon you. You will hear good news in this week in Jesus' name. I will hear good news in Jesus' name. And our joy shall be full in the name of Jesus Christ. I'll see you another time in Jesus' name. Bye.